Members, and welcome to another edition of HJ Global News. Continuing her efforts to establish the culture of the Heavenly Parents Holy Community, True Mother flew to Las Vegas, USA, to participate in the Blessing Festival entitled Peace Starts With Me, which was held on June 5th. She delivered a powerful message stating that the blessing in marriage is the one and only way to save the United States and the world. In this edition of HJ Global News, we will look back on these moving images of the event, and we will also share an excerpt from the inspirational message True Mother gave at the event. After the success of the event celebrating the 61st anniversary of True Parents Holy Wedding, which marked the beginning of this new providential spring, True Mother, in her quest for the realization of a heavenly unified Korea and a heavenly unified world, visited the United States, a nation blessed by God. On June 5th in Las Vegas, USA, the Blessing Festival entitled Peace Starts With Me took place. The event was held virtually online. The U.S. Family Federation has initiated a Blessed Family Education Program on the 40-day separation period and the 3-day ceremony. As part of the implementation of its roadmap for the restoration of one-third of the national population, which calls for 14 Blessing Festival by 2027, with 2 festivals each year. Thus, it undertook various activities that brought together more than 40,000 ACLC pastors and faithful Christians at this first festival presided over by True Mother.
The marriage blessing is probably the greatest accomplishment of Reverend and Mrs. Moon. The concept being of more of a selfless love.
Daring to dream that it's possible to create a better world and create a family, even if you didn't grow up and experience that, like that hope and that dream, that's what makes the blessing so powerful. Saying yes to that and saying yes to figuring it out.
Really embrace this different culture and discover the beauty of it. The goodness of something you don't know.
The flood came, which was worldwide. It is true that the pandemic has been cataclysmic and universal. Now is a great time for us to make that correction. And God has a woman that He has placed in this strategic time to help us to make that correction. And if we will follow her lead for peace and family blessings, then we can seriously make that correction. I introduce to you now that special lady, Dr. Hop Jahan Moon.
After inspiring testimonies from a few blessed couples, Reverend Noel Jones, who has great confidence in the American Christian world, introduced True Mother, who delivered a message of blessing, revealing, among other things, the mission of the United States in saving the world.
사랑하는 전 세계 각계 지도자 여러분, 오늘 여러분은 여러분을 따르고 있는 많은 백성들을 위해서 결단을 하여야만 할 시점에 있습니다. 나는 오늘 미국에 대해서 경고합니다. 하늘의 축복을 받은 미국으로서의 책임을 해야 된다는 말입니다. 청교도들은 하늘을 모시는 데 있어서 가정의 중요성을 알았습니다. 그러나 오늘날의 미국의 가정들은 어떠합니까? 어떻게 청소년들이 학교에서, 사회에서, 더더구나 국민학생까지 학교에서 총기를 난사하여 친구를 죽이는 일들이 일어날 수 있습니까? 나는 미국의 정치 작가에게 묻고 싶습니다. 성경에 창칼을 녹여 쟁기와 보석을 만들어 자연으로 돌아가자 했습니다. 그런데 오늘날 강대국인 미국은 왜 국민들이 총기를 가져야만 합니까? 왜 이유 없이 생명들이 죽어가야 하는 이 환경을 그냥 바라만 보고 있는 것입니까? 나는 오늘 다시 미국을 다시 깨우는 과거 청교도 정신으로 돌아가자 하는 기치를 높이며 미국이 살고 세계가 사는 길은 창조주 하나님, 우리 인류의 부모가 되고 싶으신 하늘 부모님을 모시는 일만이 모든 문제를 해결할 수 있다는 것을 강력히 주장합니다. 그러기 위해서는 참 부모의 중생 부활, 축복 결혼을 통한 다시 거듭나는 하늘 부모님의 아들, 딸로 나설 수 있는 이 참 가정 운동이야말로 미국을 살리고 세계를 살리는 길임을 나는 강력하게 선포합니다. 여러분들이 적극적으로 여러분의 종족의 실체적인 메시아가 되어서 미 국민을 축복 가정화하는 데 총력을 기울여줄 것을 부탁합니다. 그리하여 나는 미국의 모든 경제 문화의 중심인 뉴욕의 뉴욕화 호텔을 새롭게 단장하여 평화 궁전으로 만들어 세계 모든 지도자들이 와서 교육받고 참사랑 참가정운동을 실천할 수 있는 교육의 장소로 만들 것입니다. 그리고 워싱턴 중심가에 워싱턴 타임스 빌딩을 세워 밀접한 정부와의 관계에서 세계 모든 지도자들이 워싱턴을 방문하게 될 때 필히 들려서 교육받아 할 장소로서 만들고자 합니다. 이것은 미국만을 위한 길이 아닙니다. 섭리의 봄절기에 맞게 미국과 전 세계에 축복의 씨를 심는 상징적인 건물을 만들어서 하늘 부모님을 모실 수 있는 천일 성전을 봉헌하는 날과 하늘 부모님의 날을 기쁘고 감사한 마음으로 전 세계의 백성들이 함께 할 수 있는 그날을 향해서 400년 동안 수고하신 하늘 부모님 앞에 미국이 책임다하는 축복받는 장자국으로서의 사명을 다 해주기를 바래서 오늘 말씀을 통보합니다. 부디 더 이상 기회를 놓치지 않는 슬기로운 미국의 위정자와 국민들이 되기를 바라면서 이만 말씀을 종료합니다. 감사합니다.
Two mothers spoke words of love, stating that the right environment must be created to bring about a new awakening, and that the blessing is the only way to save the United States and the world. It was followed by a moving testimony of Pastor Ron Thomas and his wife, who earlier this year completed the 40-day separation period and 3-day ceremony, and are currently guiding their congregation to the blessing.
Never have I ever seen anything such as a blessing happen in the church. I am so grateful to Dr. Hak Jahan Moon, the Mother of Peace, True Mother, for the things that I have experienced and what I have seen in this movement. So 31 years we have been married, this movement has impacted me in such a positive way.
So I charge and challenge every Christian minister, bless those couples within your local congregations that their children and their children's children might be free from the destructive devices of the enemy.
After the artistic performances and testimonies, a final short but powerful message by Reverend Yong Jong-sik, North American Regional President, resounded strongly in the hearts of the participants.
It has truly changed the lives of millions of people, their relationships, their families. If we believe in the power of the Lord, our Heavenly Parent, then you also believe in the power of His blessing to change the world. Peace starts with me, with you as well.
A beautiful melody evoking the dream of peace was then played. By setting up a text us system and a website dedicated to education, the American members were able to successfully hold this event with over 40,000 people in attendance. With great joy and enthusiasm, they are determined to begin this new era of revival and to accomplish Vision 2027. On the occasion of the 30th anniversary of the admission of the two Koreas to the United Nations and the 71st anniversary of the outbreak of the Korean War, the Women's Federation and the United Nations Association of Korea held a symposium to explore ways to utilize the DMZ zone. The event was attended by more than 1,000 people on-site and online. Mrs. Julia Moon, president of the Women's Federation International, gave a speech in which she said that it is time to be creative about the DMZ. The symposium analyzed the past and present of the DMZ and the strategies and actions plans of the United Nations organization. It was chaired by Mr. Lee Seol-hang, vice president of the Korean Council on Foreign Relations. At the same time, the Women's Federation and the United Nations Association of Korea signed a Memorandum of Understanding. Through this, the two organizations confirmed their common goal to contribute to the promotion of world peace and also the promotion of ideas and activities of the United Nations. They pledged to cooperate and develop educational programs together. The Peace Road Promotion Committee and the Association of Patriots, called San Suwon, in collaboration with UPF Korea and the Citizens Federation for the Reunification of the Two Koreas, organized the launch of the Peace Road in Daegu City. After the launch ceremony, the participants walked a distance of nearly 4 kilometers. This allowed them to share the vision of Peace Road and express their longing for a heavily unified Korea. UPF Korea and Samui University Volunteer Service Center organized a campaign to distribute 100,000 masks to the unprivileged. UPF Korea Executive Secretary Lee Hyun-yong gave a lot of hope and courage to the recipients, notably wishing them to return to their normal lives as soon as possible. The Family Federation in the Philippines organized the Peace Festival, a new way of witnessing. It was held under the theme, You Are a Blessing, and was attended by nearly 5,000 people, including new members and potential new members. Through this event, they got to know the Mother of Peace and understand that God is their Heavenly Parent, as well as learn about their true identity. They committed themselves to becoming children of filial piety for God and to join the Heavenly Parents' Holy Community. After receiving a report that the suicide problem was troublesome in Sandanbeki Wakayama National Park, In Japan, True Mother asked the members to develop a preventive measure to deal with the problem. Thus, the leaders and members of Wakayama headquarters held an offering ceremony for the inheritance of heavenly fortune in the Japanese branch of the Chonpyong Training Center in order to release the evil suicidal spirits. In addition, the members conducted prayers and hundoke sessions with True Mother's autobiography in Sandanbeke. Meanwhile, the youth carried out a volunteer beach cleaning activity with the help of the municipality, thus contributing to the restoration of the local scholars. Chonbo Training Institute conducted coaching interviews with 188 church leaders in the five sub-regions of Korea, with those who have achieved the goal of 43 families. Through this, the church leaders and Chonbo Institute leaders analyzed the model cases in depth and were able to gain a deep understanding of the purpose of the 43 families that True Mother has asked them to accomplish. They pledged to align themselves with the guidelines of the international headquarters and ensure that they all become inspired by the culture of blessing for the 43 core families. True Mother said that she will renovate the New Yorker Hotel in New York City and that she will build a new Washington Times building and a peace palace in Washington, D.C., which will serve as educational centers for all world leaders. In support of True Mother, we invite you to be inspired by the words of True Parents that unveil the essence of the providence and to bring about positive change in your personal lives and the lives of your families and people around the world. Do that by witnessing the value of the blessing in marriage. This Sunday, on June 13th, there will be a special service to commemorate the 59th Day of All True Things and the 67th anniversary of the founding of the Family Federation for World Peace and Unification. We hope that many of you will follow this historic event, which will be broadcast live on the PeaceLink platform. With these words, we close this edition.